At the beginning of the film, a car is seen driving down a deserted road. Louis is the name of the man who is driving the car with his family. He is a doctor by profession. Louis's family consists of his wife Rachel and two children. Daughter's name is Ellie and son's name is Gage. They have a pet cat, called Church, and they were actually relocating from one city to another small town named Ludlow. That location is surrounded by massive trees. The following day, Louis's wife and Ellie noticed some children in the forest. They were wearing animal masks and taking a dog to the pet cemetery. Ellie moves to the pet cemetery when her mother leaves. She notices a lot of pet graves. There she sees a tall wooden wall. When Ellie tries to go to another side while climbing up the wooden wall, her foot slips and she falls down. Then an old man named Crandall arrives there. He takes out the spike pricked into Ellie's foot. He tells Ellie that the city's pet animals' graves were made here. It is an old custom for them. While searching for Ellie, her mother also reaches there. Crandall tells Ellie's mother that I am your neighbor. It is not advisable for children to move that place on their own. Ellie's mother leaves with her daughter. On another side, Louis attends an accident case in the hospital, in which a boy gets into a fatal accident and his name is Victor. Actually, we see a dangerous road near Louis's house. Cars and heavy vehicles cruise at very high speeds on that road. Victor got into an accident on that same road. Louis tries very hard to save Victor, but he couldn't save him and eventually he dies. Meanwhile, Louis notices Victor sitting in front of him and saying, "Never let the wooden barrier break." A nurse arrives before Louis could understand anything. Meanwhile, Louis notices that Victor has died already. He thinks that it may be his hallucination. Louis again hears Victor's voice when he was sleeping at night. Louis moves to the pet cemetery by following his voice. Victor's voice tells Louis that it is the place where dead bodies sleep. But on another side of the wooden wall, the dead are always alive. While Louis was also climbing the wall, Victor holds his hand and says, "Don't go there, that place is cursed." Suddenly, Louis awakes. He discovers his son in front of him and realizes that it was his dream. Louis looks down at his foot and notices something strange. His foot looks spoiled with mud. Here, Louis didn't understand that it was a dream or reality. After some days, we see his neighbor Crandall coming towards Louis and informing him that his cat has died, as it had come under a truck. Louis requests Crandall not to tell his daughter, because his daughter loves her cat so much. Crandall says to Louis that he should come to the pet cemetery at night. At night, when they both reach the pet cemetery, Crandall takes Louis to another side of the wooden wall of the pet cemetery. That location looks deserted and very quiet. They bury the cat and return to their homes. The next day, Louis and his wife make their daughter convinced that their cat has gone somewhere and could not find, even searching very hard for it. Ellie says, "How is this possible? At night, it was on my window." On it, Louis says, "No, you must have seen a dream." She points towards the cupboard and says, "Go and check, our cat is still inside." When Louis opens the door, he finds the cat inside. Its expressions and eyes were completely changed. Louis says to his wife that he misunderstood the whole incident. However, Louis is aware that something strange is taking place that humans are unable to understand. The next day, when Ellie was playing with her cat, Ellie gets injured by the cat. Louis feels strange after seeing that. The cat also attacks his son. After that incident, Louis goes to Crandall. He says to him, "We buried our cat at night, but now it is in our home." Hearing it, Crandall takes Louis inside his house. He tells Louis, "There was a tribe which lived there many years ago. It was known from the tribe's story that a demon also existed there. That demon's soul was cursed completely. The other side of the wooden wall, the place where we buried the cat, is under the demon's control even today. Anyone who is buried there will be resurrected. I also buried my dog there. When I was a kid, it had been resurrected in the same way as your cat. Later, my father killed the dog because its nature became very aggressive. In reality, my dog was aggressive even before its death. I believe that your cat's nature was not aggressive, and it would behave normally after revival. I didn't think that it will also become aggressive like my dog. After knowing that fact, Louis drops his cat at a far distance from his house. The next day we see his daughter Ellie's birthday celebrations. Ellie notices her cat approaching her from the road, and she immediately rushes forward to retrieve her cat. Ellie's brother also moves towards the road after seeing her sister. When Louis notices his son approaching the road, he rushes to stop him. A huge truck was also coming with full speed from the front. Louis saves his son's life at the right time by avoiding his son's collision with the truck. The truck driver applies a sudden brake to save both of them. As a result, the tank separates from the truck and hits Louis's daughter. She dies on the spot, because of collision with the tank. Ellie's parents become very sad because of her death. Louis's wife and son relocate to his parents' house for a few days, so that their focus may be diverted. Louis feels very dejected after missing his daughter. He goes to the place where he buried his daughter Ellie and takes out Ellie's dead body from her grave. Later, he goes to the other side of the wooden wall holding her dead body. He buries his daughter in the same place where he buried his cat. Louis sleeps after coming home. He is awakened in the middle of the night by the sound of someone's foot. When he goes to check, he notices a kid's footprints there. While following those prints, he notices that his daughter Ellie is standing in front of him. She has been resurrected. Louis becomes very happy after seeing his daughter. He hugs his daughter. However, Ellie's expressions change similar to that of the cat. He then bathes her daughter and makes her sleep with him at night. Louis was overjoyed with his daughter's recovery. The next morning, he awakes and notices his daughter Ellie was dancing strangely. He forbids Ellie to dance like that. But Ellie doesn't obey him. She becomes agitated and hurls objects at him. Now we see Louis's son who is staying at his grandmother's house. He is repeatedly seeing the soul of Victor, who was involved in an accident at the beginning of the movie. Louis has also seen Victor several times. When Rachel notices her son repeatedly calling Victor's name, she gets scared by it. Rachel calls her husband the next morning, but he does not pick her call. So, Rachel calls her neighbor Crandall. Then Crandall goes to Louis's home. He notices that Louis is behaving strangely. Crandall suspects him and says, "Look, if you made a mistake, we can make it right." But Louis refuses without any hesitation. After a while, Crandall notices Ellie in their window. With it, he realizes what Louis had done. As a result, he takes out his gun after reaching home. He is well aware that the conclusion will be perilous on what Louis has done. Many years ago, when Crandall's wife died, he also has done that to his wife's dead body. It became a bad end. Actually, he has gone through it and killed his wife. Later, Crandall realizes that there is someone else in the house except him. When he goes upstairs taking the gun, he sees Ellie. She attacks and harms him. Ellie was wearing an animal mask, and when she removes her mask, she wasn't Ellie but his dead wife. She says to him, "We are burning in that world, now we are here to take you with us." Then she kills Crandall, coming back into Ellie's getup. On another side, Rachel returns home with her son. She gets shocked seeing her daughter alive again. Louis informs her that there is a location where anyone who is buried can be resurrected. "First, I buried the cat there and it just got revived." But Rachel says, "No, our daughter is dead, we have also done her funeral." Since Rachel refuses to accept her, Ellie becomes furious. Rachel takes her son to the upper room. Louis also comes upstairs and tries to make her wife understand. Louis's wife doesn't want to listen to him. Meanwhile, Louis realizes that Ellie is listening to everything. But when he comes out, he notices that Ellie has already gone from there. And Louis also comes out of the house. He notices the light of Crandall's house is turned on. He goes towards his house searching for Ellie. When he enters the house, he discovers that he has been murdered brutally. We see Rachel with his son upstairs. Ellie comes and attacks her mother with a knife. Rachel makes her fall down while pushing her, and changes her room. She breaks the glass of the window. When she notices Louis outside, she throws her son out of the window. Louis catches him. Louis makes his son sit in the car and tells him, "If Ellie comes, don't open the door." Ellie is shown who has reached her mother. She stabs her mother with a knife several times. Rachel gets seriously injured, while Ellie was sitting next to her. Ellie says to her mother, "Mother, do you remember what father once said? There is no world after death. But it is not right, there is a world after death." Hearing it, Rachel says, "I am not your mother." Then, Ellie ends her mother. Louis also arrives and notices his wife dead. Meanwhile, Ellie attacks him from behind. Due to it, Louis gets fainted. Ellie drags her mother to the location where her father buried her. She buries her mother there and Louis also comes there. He didn't see anyone around him and hears Ellie's voice. She says, "This all happened because of you, now you have to come with us." After it, Ellie attacks Louis. There we see a brutal fight between them, but Louis has control over his daughter. He takes a shovel to put an end to Ellie's life. Before he ends her, his wife comes and ends him. Because she has also been revived by her daughter after death. The next morning, Crandall's house is shown still burning. On the other hand, Louis's son is still sitting in the car.